Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14.5 came out to the public this past week, and we've all been running it on our phones, and so I wanted to go over how it's been, what battery life is like as far as whether or not it's good or bad, whether or not you should update, as well as any remaining issues or bugs that you may or may not be experiencing based off the YouTube community poll. Now, along with that, this past week, Apple also surprisingly released iOS 14.6 Beta 1. So I have that here on an iPhone 12 Pro Max, and then I have iOS 14.5 installed on an iPhone 12 Pro Max, iPhone 11, and iPadOS 14.5 on my iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020. Now, this update I've been running full time since pretty much the release candidate on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. So it's been a couple weeks since it's the same version as the release candidate. And this particular update has one thing I haven't seen anyone else mention, and a viewer sent in named Reeve, and he sent in that he got a pop-up message or a splash screen that told him to turn on background app refresh for messages. So he was in messages just randomly using this, and it said turning on background app refresh loads your messages faster. Go to settings, turn on background app refresh. Now, this new feature is something I've never seen before, and I generally turn it off for many different things, but not everything. And in some cases, you want to leave it on if you're using those apps regularly, because it will just make it faster overall, and it really won't make a difference in battery life. However, I generally tell people to turn it off for apps they don't use a lot, because it can use additional battery life, and even Apple recommends that, to turn it off on apps that you don't use regularly. But I haven't seen this before, but let me know if you've seen this before in the comments below. Now, the overall usability of this update 14.5 is much, much better in most people's opinion than the previous versions. It's smooth most of the time for me. I really haven't had any issues on the newer phones, and even people on older phones are saying that it's generally smooth overall. That doesn't mean it is without problems. No update is perfect, and in particular, this update for me has had a couple touch responsiveness issues. Sometimes you go to touch an app, and it seems like you have to touch the app a couple different times, for example. So sometimes it can be a little odd, and you may have just seen it looked like it dropped some frames there just for a second when I went into music. Normally it's very fast, but occasionally there's some weird issues like that throughout. So it's not 100%, like I said, but it's much better than previous versions. However, there are people that were mentioning lagging and crashing. Now, in addition to that, Bluetooth has actually been quite good. Now, that could be due to the recent update of AirPods Pro and AirPods 2, for example. I tweeted about that and also posted that on the community page. So with the recent update of AirPods Pro, it seems to improve Bluetooth. However, for some reason, it just disconnected. That could be because I'm switching between devices quite a lot with these updates, trying to do the videos. So I'll reconnect that a little bit later. But in general, I have no problems with it connecting. It seems to be nice and fast after the update. And some people are saying that noise cancellation and the overall transparency feature seems to be a little bit better. I didn't notice any difference other than that it works pretty good with Bluetooth. That's something they actually said was fixed with 14.5 with it connecting, but I didn't do a video about the AirPods update because Apple did not specify what they updated at all. They just released the update. And I did post a video on how to update that quite some time ago. So if you haven't updated your AirPods, you may want to do that if you're having Bluetooth issues. Now, if you have a third-party Bluetooth device, obviously that's not going to make much of a difference. Maybe you're having a problem with your car and that sort of thing. That will have to rely maybe on a car software update or maybe future updates with iOS. Some people did mention that the phone seemed to be more warm than normal, and that could be due to the huge update that it was, where it's still processing in the background. So after a few days, if it's still irregularly warm, I generally recommend a hard reboot. That usually fixes that issue. However, some people do still mention that. One thing I haven't seen in quite some time, though, is some people are mentioning that it seems to have some issues sometimes with Touch ID or Face ID. Now, Face ID has not really been an issue for me at all. It seems to unlock nice and fast. And if you're wearing a mask using your Apple Watch, for example, it seems to work fine. Occasionally, it will be slow with that, but most of the time, it's great. So I'm not sure if you're referring to that specifically or just overall in general, but for me, thankfully, it's been fast, but quite a few people have mentioned that as well, where there's issues. We don't normally see that very often. Again, other people are mentioning touch responsiveness issues, whether that be just not recognizing touch input as fast, and others still mention green tint. Now, the majority of people say that the green tint issue has been fixed, so that's a very good sign. However, there are still some people that are seeing green tint under very rare circumstances, but if you're seeing it regularly all throughout the OS, maybe at higher brightnesses, then maybe you want to bring it to Apple. However, most people are saying that it's fixed or greatly improved, and I would not expect Apple to be done working on this because they did not directly address the word green tint in this update. Now, last year with iPhone 11 Pro and iPhone 11 Pro Max, Apple actually patched the issue, mentioning specifically green tint, and they mentioned that they fixed it last August. So it took them almost an entire year to fix that problem in the 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max. So they definitely could still be working on it. Some people say that it's hardware, but based off what they did last year with the iPhone 11 Pro, I would say it's more software based since it improved greatly with 14.5 for most people. Now, there are still some people saying they have issues with app tracking. In fact, right after I did my iOS 14.5 What's New video, quite a few people commented on the new privacy feature under settings where you go to tracking and it says allow apps to request to track. Now, this was grayed out for a lot of people. However, since then, quite a few people have seen this sort of just pop back to life from maybe a server side push, or maybe you updated to beta 1 or beta 2 of iOS 14.6, as that seems to have fixed it with that update. So this particular update, I would recommend leaving it off, which doesn't mean that the feature is off. It just means that you won't be prompted to have anything track you, and that it's blocking all tracking in the background between apps. If you want it turned on, you can leave it on, and then apps will request one by one. That's why I generally recommend leaving it off if you just don't want anything to track you. So it's a little bit confusing. Maybe they will actually clarify that with some wording in the future, but right now, just leave it off. Generally, when it's off, it just means it's not tracking you at all. So it's on, but you're not being bothered. It's more of a notification button than anything else, where it will ask you about it. Additional people are still having issue with Wi-Fi. Now, I haven't had these issues anymore with this update since probably beta 8, and I think they fixed some things. Now, if you're still having issues, you may want to check for a router update for your home router for Wi-Fi. However, you shouldn't necessarily have to do that. But in the past, quite some time ago, Apple had quite a few problems with different corporate routers where they would push an update and then the router needed to be updated to comply with whatever standard or change that they made. So it's possible they did something like that if you're still having issues, but the people that are having issues say that it disconnects from Wi-Fi. Now, with iOS 14.6 beta 2, there was not a whole lot new in this update, and generally it's fairly too early to tell how the overall usability and performance was. With beta 1, people did report issues. Some people reported slowdowns or just general odd issues, but it seems to be pretty stable and a small update as well. But with iOS 14.6 beta 2, it's a fairly small update that should be out probably much faster than we saw iOS 14.5. So there's not really a whole lot new in 14.6 beta 2 yet, but maybe we'll see a lot more new with beta 3. Most things, though, will probably be pushed until iOS 15 as far as any future major updates. So the overall general usability of 14.6, I would say, is good, but we still need more time to determine how it is. Now, with iPadOS 14.5, in general, it's been pretty great. Throughout all of the betas and everything else, the overall performance, usability, the experience has been really what you would expect on an iPad. The general usability has been great, with the exception of maybe the YouTube app from time to time sort of locking up, but then YouTube would push a new update to the app and it would be fine again. So I think that's an app-specific problem, and the overall usability of the iPad with 14.5 has been great, with one exception. Throughout all of the betas and even the release candidate and this final version, which is the release candidate, battery life has been poor up until about today. You'll see it was last charged to 82% at 10:06 a.m. and about 12 hours later or so, we are down to 71%. This is the first day I've actually seen decent battery life on the iPad. Most of the time I'm getting about 5 to 6 hours of screen on time, where I should be getting 9 or 10 or with regular use, just sort of watching YouTube, occasionally using documents, mail, Safari, things like that. So in general, it's doing good now. If it continues to perform badly with battery life, being that it has about 96% battery health using coconut battery, I think I may format this or update it to iPadOS 14.6 beta 2 is sort of a last resort. If that doesn't fix it, then I'll start over. We'll give it another day or two. Otherwise, I'll probably have to start over with this. And I don't mind that. There's new iPads coming out and it's worth trying out and seeing if it improves just from doing that. When it comes to iOS 14.5 battery life, my battery life has actually been pretty good. My battery health is at 100%. This is my main iPhone since the day it came out. And I charge it every single night on a fast charger using MagSafe. So it's doing quite well. I charge it when I'm driving the car as well. Quite a few people are still seeing the recalibration message in iPhone 11, 11 Pro, and 11 Pro Max. And it can take a couple weeks for this. And with all the updates coming out, this will take some time, but quite a few people are seeing their battery health capacity go up in that version with iPhone 11 and 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max. So people that are concerned about that, I wouldn't be concerned about battery health. It's normal for it to go down over time, and I expect mine to drop soon. However, battery life with 14.5 has actually been pretty good. It hasn't been incredible, but it's been decent. So if we go back a few days, you'll see I had 2 hours and 52 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 14 minutes of screen off time, and used about 30% of my battery. If we multiply this by maybe a total length of 100% usage, we're going to hit that 10 to 12 hours of screen on time that most people expect. Some people say that they're getting more battery life by far with this update. And based off the YouTube community poll with about 104 comments that I went over where people said it was good or bad or the same, 77% of you said that battery life was improved over the previous versions that you were running. Only 23% say that it wasn't that great or they were having issues. However, they may not have taken into account to give it a few days to sort of finish background processing. But most people see a significant increase. And since counting all of these battery statistics that I've done in the past, this is by far the most amount of people saying that battery life has improved. And that leads me to, should you install iOS 14.5? Well, based off just battery life alone, I would say yes. Based off security, absolutely. And based off the features that you gain, I would say for sure. It's much, much more stable than we had with previous versions. And most people are saying this is what iOS 14 should have been from the start, and it took a long time to get right. That's a good sign because it's only going to get better from here in most cases, where they'll sort of stabilize everything, get it ready to go for everyone else, make sure it's solid until the next version comes out. So yes, I highly recommend installing it specifically for security, yes, for battery life and the updates and everything else. So I know some people are concerned about that. And I definitely would say after a few days of installing it and everything finishes in the background, then you'll see an improvement if you don't before then. Now, as far as if you should install iOS 14.6 beta 2 or even beta 1, I would say if you want to try it out, you have a secondary device, go ahead. But if you're trying to remedy something you're having an issue with 14.5 or an earlier version, I would pass on the betas because at this point, 14.5 is the solid version released to the public. If you want to try out a beta, there's not really any huge new features in this update yet. Some changes with podcasts, for example. So there will be some additional features in the future, I think, but right now it's not anything truly exciting. If you're a developer, of course, you've probably already updated to test your app or something like that. So that makes sense for those reasons. Now, as far as iOS 14.6 and when to expect that being released to the public, well, based on what we know already from the release of the new iPad and the new iMac, Apple actually added support for those in iOS 14.6 or iPadOS 14.6 and macOS 11.4. So we need those versions to have support for the new iPad and the iMac, which supposedly come out on the 21st of May. So we should have it in the first week of that week. So maybe the 17th, 18th, although they could put a smaller version in between to support those. So we have to wait and see, but based on the rate that they're pushing this update out already, it's rare that we have a beta 2, maybe a week or so after beta 1. So that seems likely that we'll see that probably in the second half of May or somewhere around the 21st, for example. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now at the time of this video, there are 25,000 votes. So I really appreciate anyone that voted and 602 comments. That's an incredible amount. And 66% of you say that the update is great. Always 3% say that it's terrible for some reason, but it seems to be consistent. 13% are saying it has some bugs. 12% either have not updated yet or are or are on 14.6 beta 1, and then 6% of you are using something else other than that, whether that be Android or maybe an older version. Now let's go into the comments and take a look at some of them. Maybe about 10 of them. There's 602. This is available to read. If you have an iPhone or a computer, you can read these as well. But let's take a look at some of these comments. And the first one from James Morrison says, "XS Max, doing good so far. Battery life is okay. Have to see more longer." Alexander says, "On my iPhone 12, battery is a lot better. I did not notice any bugs." Now, hopefully I can say this properly. Nurruddin Kachwala said, "Hi, Aaron. It works great on my iPhone 6S. Just draining battery fast. Hope it gets better soon. Love your videos. Stay safe, buddy." And thank you. And this particular update, I think maybe give it a few more days. Battery health could definitely be affected, which would make battery life worse as if it's degrading over time quickly. But either way, this update, give it a few more days. Hopefully the battery life improves, but I did want to show someone that actually said they had poor battery life. But again, 77% of you have said that it's actually better. GoGetta or GoJetta Blue said, "I don't notice anything too different, but everything has been working fine and my battery life hasn't been impacted in any way. So that's a win in my books. I own a white iPhone 11. Love your videos and look forward to watching the next one." And thank you. Jakari's One Way Solution said, "iPhone 11 is now fast with great battery improvement, no lag with AT&T, now protecting my phone from disturbing ads, and now I'm ready to go smoothly within my apps and enjoy iOS 14.5 fully." Yash Singhavi says, "There's a small bug for me in iMessage. After I've sent a message, the keyboard is just stuck there. I have to exit the app and go back in, and then it works fine." Ashwari says, "iPhone SE first generation, and it's better than expected. Highlight is the battery life. It's great." Will Marklu says, "iPhone XS seems to be having issues with battery connectivity to wireless headphones," and they're Sony headphones, "and wireless speaker to Bose speakers, but apart from that, all good. For some reason, people continue to have these Bluetooth issues, so there's definitely something that changed. Hopefully it gets improved pretty soon." Ahmed22 says, "Using it on my XS Max and it's great. No issues so far. I recommend it." Vasil Vadafu says, "It's really good. I've installed it on all my devices except for one, which I'm using for other betas. Definitely, I recommend it to everyone to install." James says, "I'm using this on my 12 Pro Max. Overall, it's been perfect. Battery drain was a little rough the first couple of days, but that seemed to have normalized." Mr. Sammy Phoenix said, "I'm glad to report that the LCD-like glow when viewing a black wallpaper has been fixed on my iPhone 12 Pro Max." NinjaMat55 says, "I'm using an iPhone 11. It's very awesome and nice battery life. It doesn't seem too different, but it's still lasting me the day, and battery health is still recalibrating. Although I don't know why, it could be because I don't have an app that has this feature. But for some reason, the allow apps to request a track is still grayed out and with no app below the toggle. I hope you can tell me the reason." And hopefully I explained that a little bit earlier on. So that should be updated either in 14.6 or hopefully pushed with the server side. Mike Coeb says, "iOS 14 is getting better and better. iOS 14.5 fixed for me the green tint completely on my iPhone 12 Pro Max and almost fixed the raised blacks," or the black level that someone said was fixed before. "I feel in iOS 14.6, the display issue will be resolved completely, and as earlier days, the battery life seems great." We'll read a couple more. Kurush Unwala says, "11 and I feel battery life has increased ever so slightly. Early days, will observe it over the coming days." Ibuka Akafor says, "My battery life has greatly improved on iPhone 12. Goyle says, "It's okay, neither good or bad. I think battery life improved a little. Didn't like the music app tweaks, especially with the sub menu. And then I'm using it on my iPhone XR and it's working pretty good for me." And so iOS 14.5 seems to be a huge fix for most people. Hopefully it continues to improve. If you just installed it, I would look for the battery life to improve over the next few days. So that's it for iOS 14.5 and 14.6 beta 2. I'm looking forward to see what Apple has next with new features with iOS 15, for example, and hopefully some huge changes with the new iPad with all the power that has with the M1 chip with iPadOS 15. So I'm looking most forward to that at WWDC 2021. But if you found anything else new in this particular update 14.5 that I didn't mention or 14.6 beta 2, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.